Hello and welcome back to my channel, and today we're playing Draugen. Well, I think this is the last part because we had the biggest revelation of all. Is this?
Goodbye, Betty.
Is that Betty is not even Betty? Okay, I thought you were missing. She's not. Okay. So we are going to discover more about the story. Okay, so Alice is back. I still do not know what the fuck is Alice. Alice is
It's a beautiful day. Had your noodle juice yet?
I might be weaned off this stuff.
Boo. Don't lose your taste for tea, old fruit. It keeps you human. We have unfinished business.
We do?
The final piece of the puzzle.
Ruth.
Come on. Let's go back to where it started. We have an appointment with a ghost.
So, we have to deal with the curse, I think.
Such an amazing view, isn't it? And the air. Ugh. Why did we come
here? Understand the
well,
Alice.
Some places have gravity.
What are you saying? Gravewick's gravity pulled us across the Atlantic Ocean?
No, I'm not saying that. That's rational.
But you believe, don't you, that we were summoned to tell their story?
Letter to Frederick.
The one you found in his safe. From Boston.
I may have overheard a conversation somewhere. Paid it no attention, but the name stuck. And Betty... And I spun a story around it that put us on this path.
Do you really believe that? I mean, how often are you around people?
To find my sister.
But Betty's not. She was never here. It doesn't make sense.
I'm a man of science. I don't know what to believe.
And yet, here we are. All three of us.
Is this what you wanted to show me?
I wanted to be close to her. Do you believe in ghosts, Edward?
You know I don't.
Well, you've been chasing one for years.
That's different.
What about me? Us.
You're not ghosts. You're alive.
Fair enough. So what really happened to
you? What are you? You're not a ghost, you're a lifeless, so what are you?
I believe it was an accident.
How? What happened?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Alright, she ran from the mine and came here. And then... Was she afraid? What made her run?
Something spooked her.
And she panicked. So she ran here. Why not home? She couldn't go home. Or she didn't want to. She felt safe. This was her happy place. And then... If only Ruth had wings, like an angel, she could have flown straight to heaven. I hope she's at peace. And with God. Do you think that's where everyone's gone?
Heaven. They're dead. I don't know what that means. Maybe there is more. I can't stop you from hoping. We'll never know what happened to everyone in Draugen.
We tried our best. We'll remember them. All of them. Maybe that will give them some peace in the afterlife. Could this be your book, Edward? The one you've been wanting to write? A story about people who are isolated, left behind by the world. You can give them all a proper ending, with no annoying loose thread. Edward! Is that...
Post? But how?
Who cares? Let's catch it before it sets out on another adventure!
I don't understand how this can be. It must have been the wind.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, teddy bear. Let's blouse, while the weather's still good.
I need my suitcase.
So get a wiggle on, old boy. I'm going to say my goodbyes to all the things. I don't think we'll be back. Meet you at the house.
My goodness. Righty-ho. No rush. We have all day.
I'll draw the scenery. No, I don't. I don't want to. It's a pretty weird, interesting game. Yes. I know that they put a lot of effort into the the story, but it could be more interesting if they dwell in too deep with the roof story. Because now we have three separate stories, which is Ruth, Betty, and Alice. Alice and the marble angel, I think. So kind of three stories. And I want to see the body. Is the body still there? Or is it a figment of imagination? Okay, the room cannot be open. Suitcase over here.
You know, this house is starting to grow on me.
This is a huge ass house, but it's empty.
Teddy, pack your things. I'll meet you by the boat.
Do you never sit still?
Don't be a wet blanket. Let's make like the wind and get at it.
I can see that's not even the same brooch.
Let's go! Row, Teddy, row! The water's still cold.
It's a fjord, Lissy. And it's almost winter.
There'll be snow when we get back to Hanover.
The house will be warm.
Are we going to be all right, Edward?
I think so.
That is a weird ending for this game, but it's done. Here's my 2 cents for the game. It's pretty good. It's pretty awesome. The gameplay, I don't care much about the gameplay. The gameplay is mild. It's okay. It's a game. But the story is good. It's strong. When the first part of the story, when we saw the shadows up in the window, that's a strong part of the story. You can do more on that, and you can make it more on the horror and mystery part. But this all is just mystery, and all I can see was a pigment, or maybe I'm just going with the wind. That I'm going with the what I see, but what I didn't explore that much in this game. I didn't go to a place, and the part where I just get out from the window. Like I go into the stall, I go into the shed, and then just go out into the window. I didn't walk around the house, and I didn't see enough evidence. I didn't see enough things that can make this game a complete story. So for me, the narrative is there, but it is not complete. It is not strong. So it's okay. It's a good game. And thank you for watching playing this game. If you like this channel, hit this subscribe button. If you like my video, hit the thank you. Bye-bye.